Coming up on Mountain News this morning, Kentucky health officials remind men in our region to focus on their health. Then a Kentucky hospital shows some appreciation for first responders during a special ceremony.
Dedicated to Eastern and Southern Kentucky, this is WYMT Mountain News this morning.
All righty, it's Friday finally, almost 6:32. You know what I should have done? I should have just sat here in silence until it hit 6:32. But I feel like Brandon would probably get upset with me. So let's head over to him for the latest look at our weather this morning. Brandon, as you said earlier, the heat is making its way out of here. And boy, are we jazzed for that.
Oh, buddy, I can't tell you how excited I am to see that heat.
It's been miserable this week.
Yes,
miserable.
My outside time in Dakota has consisted of me walking from my house to the car, into the station, back out to my car, into my house, and that's literally it.
And one thing about me is I'm not an outdoorsy person, so this is just perfect for me because why do I want to go outside?
I just couldn't. And I am most of the time an outdoorsy person, but even when we got out to water plants, it was 7-8 o'clock at night, so that's when it was finally decent enough to get outside a little bit, but it's just been miserable this
week. Staying in my house, watching TikTok, do not bother me.
Exactly. But the good news is, today, we're gonna get rid of some of this heat temporarily, but it could be back sooner than you think, and it could be worse than this week. Yeah, I wanted summertime. All right, let's get into it this morning. Buffalo Mountain first. We're looking again at some warmer temperatures up there, 75 there and in Hazard. We see blue skies and a little bit of sunshine up there. 77 Jackson, Prestonsburg, and Moorhead, 69. Manchester and Middlesboro, 68. Jonesville and Wise, the coolest spot in the region, 66 in Clintwood. It is 76 in Pikeville. So a few spots like Pikeville, Prestonsburg, and Jackson, all a bit warmer. Hazard, too, the warmest spot in the region right now by from yesterday, if you're not counting Charleston. But you got a few spots at a few degrees colder this morning, like Wise and Jonesville, Middlesboro, and Monticello. So again, back and forth this afternoon, I do believe before the front hits, we'll get into the mid to upper 80s. I'm forecasting 89. We'll see if we make it. It's kind of hard to pin down because it's already warm this morning. We just got to see if we can get to 89 before the rain hits. But again, we'll cool off real nice tonight. Humidity will go down. Dew points will go down. We'll be in the 60s by tomorrow morning. Dakota.
All right, Brendan, thank you. Well, Kentucky State Police released the names of two people found dead Wednesday night. The two women were found in the Lost Creek community of Breathitt County. Police say 77-year-old Brenda Mullins and 76-year-old Sharon White were inside a home. Well, KSP reports that one of the victims started a car that was parked in a garage below the house, causing both women to die of carbon monoxide poisoning. No foul play is suspected. A woman trusted to care for and protect kids has been arrested on a number of child sex crimes. April Bradford is now a suspended assistant principal at South Floyd Elementary School. Investigators say her arrest comes decades after the alleged crimes involving the sexual assault of minors first dating back more than two decades ago. The charges are related to claims made by two victims who were minors between 1997 in 2007, at the time the alleged crimes occurred. State police say at this time they are not aware of any other victims. Bradford was taken to the Floyd County Detention Center, but is out on bond. And the Floyd County School Superintendent released a statement. You can find that on WYMT.com. One Central Kentucky county is taking steps to combat the opioid epidemic. The Woodford County Fiscal Court just launched a new campaign, and it's aimed to educate people about the risks and dangers of painkillers. Grayson Passmore explains.
I lost my son in 2017. I lost him to a drug overdose.
Versailles District 6 Magistrate Larry Blackford details his son's addiction.
My son had called me, said, "Dad, I want to talk to you." He said, "Dad, I want you to know I'm an addict. I'm addicted to opioids."
Blackford sharing his family's story through the new Woodford Aware campaign video. Judge Executive James Kay helped create the initiative as part of the county's opioid task force.
It doesn't discriminate. It affects every family. Even if it hasn't hit home to people and they're blessed not to have that in their family, it's so much closer than people realize.
Kay's goal is to reduce the number of opioid pills prescribed legally in the county.
But we wanted to make sure that our doctors are telling folks about the dangers and the risks.
Addiction to opioids can happen within a matter of days. It's recommended that any opioid prescription try to be kept to 3 days or less.
Kay says doctors throughout the county agree that unless necessary, these addictive painkillers should not be prescribed over medicines like Tylenol and acetaminophen.
But what we want to do is bring our doctors and our community together to say, hey, these risks are serious, they're dangerous, and they're causing problems.
In Woodford County, Grayson Passmore, WKYT.
Well, Kay says they're also working to get athletic trainers involved in the campaign, hoping to spread the message to young athletes as well. Well, June is Men's Health Month, a month where healthcare workers are going the extra mile to encourage men to get their annual wellness checks. The checks can consist of life-saving tests that you can diagnose, that can diagnose you with an illness or disease before you ever feel sick, giving you a greater chance at beating it.
If you love a man, encourage him to do that. If you are a man, I encourage you to do that. Come in and see us.
Men are less likely to seek or treatment or medical help when needed, but especially when they are healthy. But healthcare workers say sometimes they just need a boost. Well, yesterday was the second annual blessing of the rigs at CHI St. Joseph in London. Blessings of the Rig of the Rigs was created to show appreciation of EMS first responders and police by bringing them food, drinks, and having a priest pray over them.
It's an annual event that we're going to start doing just to show the first responders how much we appreciate them and part of our human kindness campaign for the facility and the market.
The idea was originally created last year when the pandemic was still booming to show appreciation for first responders, but they wanted to continue to thank them for their service every year. WYMT anchor Steve Hensley sat down Wednesday with Lawrence County native and recent American Idol winner Noah Thompson. He is the first Eastern Kentuckian to win the show. Many people across our region were glued to their TVs each week to see how far Noah would make it in the competition. Well, Noah talked with us about his time on American Idol and what he plans to do next.
My name is Noah Thompson. I'm 19 years old, and I'm a construction worker.
In a few short weeks,
we did everything from sheetrock to
that construction
work,
worker quickly down, became a household remodel, name. Like most five, kids growing up, really Noah wanted to be someone. He wanted to play music and be famous.
What's up?
What's up, man? How y'all doing?
It all took off after his first audition in front of judges Lionel Richie, Katy Perry, and Luke Bryan. But his friend Arthur Johnson signed him up for the show.
He was just kind of, I guess he was probably sitting in his chair being lazy, scrolling through his phone, and he came upon these American Idol auditions. He told me he was going to sign me up, and I was like, no.
While on the show, Noah stayed true to his hometown roots, even bringing country music star Carrie Underwood to tears.
This show was created for people like me and for people like Noah who didn't know to dream that big but knew that they wanted to do something. So it's a beautiful thing.
Her and I were just kind of the same when it comes to, you know, coming from a small town or, you know, not really having as much opportunity as everybody else had. You know what I mean? Like, kind of get out and do what you love. So
the show was not always easy. The singer performed from his hotel room as he battled COVID.
I was in my hotel room for 8 days, so it was awful.
And you performed, two songs in your hotel room?
A short time later, his hometown of Louisa threw a welcome home parade, drawing huge crowds supporting their hometown hero.
I had no idea how many people were actually going to be there, you know. So that was pretty amazing for me to see the outcome of that.
After the nationwide vote,
nearly 1 month ago was the moment Noah, his family, and many across Eastern Kentucky hoped and prayed for.
Noah Thompson!
I did not expect to win at all. I came into this show just scared out of my mind and had no clue what I was doing.
As the shock of winning still lingers, the singer has big plans as his career takes off, like wanting to write more originals.
I believe God has a plan for everything, and this was, for some reason, some crazy reason, this was supposed to happen, so.
As Katy Perry said to Noah,
you are the American dream.
And also an inspiration to Eastern Kentucky. Dakota Makris, WYMT Mountain News. Our interview with Noah Thompson airs Monday night at 7 o'clock right here on WYMT. American Idol airs on ABC. Auditions for the next season are now open. You can find that link over on WYMT.com.
.641 here on this Friday morning. We continue to track a little bit of cloud cover across parts of our region, but the rain is staying to the south, at least for now. Not for long, because it's coming in even closer, moving into parts of central Illinois and working its way toward the Kentucky border here in the next couple of hours. It's moving pretty fast, too. This has just been in the last basically 6 hours. Actually, the last couple hours, you see it moving basically into, again, about the I think it's the Peoria area down there toward Carbondale a little bit there. So we're going to continue to watch that as we head into the next couple of hours. It's going to be our neck of the woods here pretty soon. 66 Clintwood, 78 again in Prestonsburg. That's our range this morning. A lot of 60s and 70s out there this morning. Breakfast forecast, not too bad temperature-wise. A little cooler than it was this time yesterday, but it's still muggy, so you're still going to kind of get the air you can wear feeling as you walk out the door. But by this time tomorrow morning, jackets might be needed. So it's going to be a nice transition and a nice change of pace there as we head deeper into the night tonight and tomorrow. We've got to get through some storms first. Those should roll in here later this morning. Dakota?
All right, Brendan, thank you so much. It's 6:42 when we come back. Carroll Mountain News this morning. Senate negotiators continue to debate the sticking points in a new gun safety bill. Stay with us. That's coming up next.